Students, Olevels online present the video lecture series for books of original entry. In this video, we will discuss the introduction of the topic. This video series is helpful for those students who are appearing in Cambridge Olevels upcoming exams, either in June or November through CAIE or IGCSE for accounting 7707 or 0452. Let's begin the lesson material. Why books of original entry? Due to business growth, it provides the thought to the business that it has to record all business dealings or the transaction on the valuable platform. A large number of organizations will not handle their huge transactions in one ledger, so it is necessary to develop their books of entries accordingly. Businesses want to keep a similar type of transactions together with a book of each type. It will provide them with accuracy and accountability when the need arises. Definition of books of original entry refer to the accounting journals in which business transactions are initially recorded and summarized to prepare financial statements. We will discuss this working map in upcoming slides in this video. There are six types of books of original entry. Number one is sales day book. Number two is purchase day book. Number three is written inwards day book. The fourth one is written outwards day book. The fifth one is cash book, and finally general ledger. We will discuss each one in upcoming videos. Let's see the types of ledgers. There are three types of ledgers. Number one is a sales ledger, second is purchase ledger, and the third one is general ledger. Let's see the working map of books of original entry. Let's see its placement in working regarding books of original entry. Books of original entry working map. Let's see its working. The first step in the working map is recording business transaction in related T accounts and get debit or credit balances from them. This is a step number one, and we had a detailed discussion in our previous videos. If you missed these, kindly check it with referred video link in the upper corner in the slide. After that, we have a second stage, that is classification. In this section, we will classify all transactions which was incurred in the business. The classification as follows: credit sales, credit purchases, return inwards, return outwards, cash receipt and payments, and other types. Let's see a further step. After the classification of the transaction, we have a third step, that is the development of day books. Credit sales recorded in sales day book, credit purchases in purchases day book, return inwards in return inwards day book, return outwards in return outwards day book, cash receipt and payments in the cash book, and other types recorded in a general journal. The word general means not special, and journal means record. Let's move to the next step. In step 4, we have related ledgers. Sales day book produce sales ledger, purchase day book produce purchase ledger, and general produce general ledger. How many types of accounts? There are two major types of accounts: personal accounts and impersonal accounts. Personal accounts consist of debtors and creditors. Impersonal accounts have two more divisions, that are real and nominal. Real accounts use possession of all kinds in business as an asset. Nominal accounts used for expense, income and capital. Hopefully you got a clear understanding of books of original entry. If you have any query regarding the lesson, kindly ask in the comment section of this video. You can download the related formats and lesson material through the link provided below. Thanks for watching. I hope you learned something new today. If you did, like and share video with other people to learn from it, and please subscribe to my channel if you want to see more video like this. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next lesson.